Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. There is a man who is dominating the Bay Area International 2019. His name is Emilio Cordova, 28 years old, Grandmaster from Peru with a rating of 2600. The Bay Area tournament is a 9-round open and after 8 rounds Cordova is leading with 6 points and a half. The game that I'm going to show you is Cordova versus Jeffrey Xiong from round 6. A rated advanced variation, something that we don't see often, and a beautiful game. So let's start to review the game together. Cordova with the white pieces opens with knight to f3, the rated opening, and Jeffrey Xiong answers with d5. c4 now, attacking the pawn immediately, and d4 the advanced variation. b4. g5 in the style of Morozevich with the idea to push again, forcing the knight to move away. Capturing the pawn now is not a good idea, because after knight capture on g5, here comes e5 with the discovery attack. Knight goes back to e4, bishop capture on b4, this pawn is pinned, a3 attacking the bishop, bishop to e7, and black is better, especially for his space advantage in the center. So after g5, Cordova plays h3, controlling g4, h6, defending g5, bishop to b2, attacking the d4 pawn, and bishop to g7, developing the bishop and protecting the pawn. But the pawn becomes pinned. So Cordova plays e3, attacking the pawn that is pinned, e5 now, c5, good move because clears the c4 square for the bishop, and black can't play d4, of course, because the e5 pawn will fall. So knight to e7, bishop to c4, castle for black, and e4 now by Cordova. e4 blocking the e-pawn on the dark square so that the black bishop becomes less useful. There is a funny thing to consider though. The same pawn chain is also blocking the dark bishop of the white player. And playing e4, white lost a tempo without developing a piece. So right now, black is better. Knight in b goes to c6, attacking the pawn. a3, protecting b4. b6, attacking the most advanced pawn, c capture on b6, c recapture on b6, d3, bishop to d7, better than in fianchetto in this position, knight in b goes to d2, and b5. This is an interesting pawn sacrifice, but what is the idea? The idea is this, that after bishop capture on b5, here comes knight capture on b4 with the discovery attack. Of course, white can't capture the bishop because the knight will capture, we check. If a capture on b4, bishop capture on b5, again attacking this pawn, that is the weakest pawn, black wins the bishop pair, and the bishop goes away from the line of the queen that is free to develop to d6 in the center of the board. So black, it's a bit better before this sequence. So that's why after knight capture on b4, Cordova doesn't capture with the pawn, but goes back with the bishop. Bishop to c4, protecting the pawn and away from the black bishop attack. Knight to c6. The knight goes back. Now, short castle is a good idea for white, but Cordova plays h4, that is riskier. Maybe instead, we already said that short castle is good. Another good move maybe is a4, that clears the a3 square for the dark square bishop, that in this position is severely limited by the black pawn chain. We said h4. g4 now, attacking the knight. Knight goes back to h2, and rook to b8 attacking the bishop. Bishop to c1 and h5. f3 in this position is a good move because capturing on f3 only helps white to untangle this position. So here comes knight to g6 with the idea to jump with the knight in this beautiful outpost. Cordova plays g3, controlling the outpost, but this knight is so good that here comes another very good move, knight capture on h4. Cordova in this position doesn't capture the knight and castles, and this is a good idea, because if g capture on h4, here comes h3, g3 attacking the knight. The knight must go back to f1, g2 is a fork, rook to g1 to save at least the rook. Before capturing the knight, queen capture in h4 we check, king to e2, now the pawn capture and promotes we check, queen recapture on f1, nothing is lost, but black is better and really this position is a bit uncomfortable for white. Cordova, after knight capture on h4, he castles. Now the knight can be captured, so the knight goes back to g6. Here comes f capture on g4, also clearing the file for the rook. h4. King to g2, it would be a terrible mistake, because black capturing g3, attacking the knight, forces the king to capture, but on g3, black can give check with the queen on h4. King to g2, the knight jump with check in the outpost. The best square now for the king is king to h1, but this position is really terrible for black. So after h4, g capture on h4, queen capture on h4, and knight in d goes to f3, attacking the queen. Queen to e7, now another good move, bishop to g5, attacking the queen. Let's remember that this pawn is pinned, so black can't play f6. Playing bishop to f6 is an inaccuracy, because after knight to h4, black with bishop capture on g5 wins the bishop pair, but lose the quality. Again, this pawn is pinned. And the queen must move to d6, now comes knight capture and rook capture. So because the queen at the end must go to d6, after bishop to g5, the best move is queen to d6. And we see that with the last moves, starting from the good idea short castle instead of capturing, Cordova was able to stabilize his king side, and now the game is roughly equal. Knight to h4 forces black to capture, knight capture on h4, bishop recapture on h4, and good move by Jeffrey Xiong, knight to a5 attacking this bishop, because this light square bishop is really powerful on this diagonal and is pinning also the pawn. Of course, Cordova moves away the bishop to d5, but bishop to c6, now white is forced to the change. Bishop capture on c6, and here Xiong plays queen capture on c6, and this is a mistake that leaves the knight in an awkward position. It was much better to recapture with the knight. If knight capture on c6, now g5, knight to e7, the knight goes to the sensible part of the board. And after knight to g4 with the idea on knight to f6, there is knight to g6 attacking one of the defenders of the f6 square. And this is an equal position and a good defense by black. But after queen capture on c6, here white starts to be better. g5, rook to b2, knight to g4, and there are two dangerous jumps for this knight. Queen to e6, and here white has a very good move in his cards. Let's watch. At first, let's watch why knight to f6 now doesn't fully work. Because after bishop capture on f6, and rook capture in f6, attacking the queen, but the queen can go to h3, attacking the bishop, guarding d3, and also threatening checkmate in one on h2, so the bishop must go back to f2, and the initiative is completely lost for white. So this move doesn't work because the queen can infiltrate through this diagonal. The exclamation mark move is rook to f5, closing the light diagonal for the queen that can't reach h3 anymore after rook in f goes to b8, doubling the rooks on the b5. Now comes knight to f6 with check, and if bishop capture on f6, it's already game over, because here comes g recapture on f6, the queen can move to g4 with check or to h5, the king must start to move away, king to f8, queen to h5, threatening mate in one, king to e8, but here comes rook capture, protected by the queen on e5, and this is a winning skewer. So after knight to a6 we check, the only move to keep playing is king to f8, but again the queen infiltrate on h5. Here comes rook to b1 we check, rook capture we check, and king to g2, a very good square, because when attacked the king must move to a square where it's easy to interfere with this check. Rook to b2 we check, the bishop goes back, protected also by the rook and by the king. This rook here doesn't work anymore. Rook to b7, queen to h7, the idea is to or give checkmate starting with queen to g8 we check, or capturing directly the bishop. So bishop capture on f6, here comes queen to h6 we check. Of course the bishop can't go back to g7 because the queen is lost, because this pawn is pinned. So after queen to h6 we check, king to e7, the only move, and rook capture the bishop, attacking the queen. The queen moves away with check, but after king to h2, now the king is on a square where the black queen can't give any more checks, and if black allows queen to h7, then this pawn will fall with check and it's game over. So rook to b6, at least attacking the rook, rook capture, a capture, queen to f6 we check, king to e8, because if king to f8 seems better, no? But white will force again the king here to e8, because after king to f8 there is queen to h8 we check, the king must go back, and again the queen will capture on e5 we check, king to f8, with white that will also win another pawn, and it's more than plus 3 in this position, white will win the endgame. So going back, rook to f5 was a really great move, but Cordova plays queen to f3 because he sees this idea, this possibility of the queen to go to h3, but was much better the other solution. Now comes rook to c8, rook in a goes to b1, challenging the rook, rook capture, and knight to b3 with a forking idea. Knight to f6 we check, bishop capture, g capture, it's time for the king to run away, because there is always this mating one threat. King to f8, and queen to d1 by Cordova. This is a second attack on the knight. It's not the best move, because the game in this position is roughly equal. To keep the equality, the best move is queen to h5, and this is a tempo move, because again, this king must move away. Queen to h5 not only threatens mate, also start to attack the e5 pawn. After queen to h5, the king must move to e8. Now comes bishop to g3, and there is no way to protect the pawn. King to d7, bishop capturing e5, and the game is still equal. After queen to d1, if black plays knight to c5, the queen has no good squares where to go on the queen side, and the queen to h8 idea doesn't work anymore, because after king to e8 and bishop to g3, there is knight capture on d3, not only wins the pawn, but also protect the e5 pawn. So black is better even before bishop to g3. But after queen to d1, here comes the blunder. Let's watch. Jeffrey Xiong plays queen to h3, leaving the protection of the knight with the idea to threaten the bishop and to threaten the king. But Cordova plays the same move that always comes with tempo, queen to h5. Again, there is the checkmate threat on h8, so the king must move king to e8. And here, not rook capture, let's pay attention, because if rook capture now, black will win in 5 moves, with rook to c1 we check, king to f2, rook to f1 we check, king to e2, queen to g2 we check, the only move is to interfere with the bishop, and then queen capture the checkmate. So after king to e8, the important thing is to win material. Queen capture on e5 we check, king to d7, queen to d5 we check. Here it's not so simple to find the last blow, king to e8, and again Cordova goes back to queen to e5 we check, king to f8 and queen to g5 protecting the bishop and guarding the king, looking for the winning move, queen to e6 protecting the knight, bishop to g3, Rook to c3, attacking the pawn, bishop to e1. This is a good move because not only the bishop is attacking the rook, but now the bishop is also placed on this important diagonal that will attack the king from the other side. Capturing with the rook on d3 is wrong, because after bishop to b4 we check and king to e8 there is Queen to b5, we check that wins the rook. So after bishop to e1, Xiong plays rook to c6, bishop to a5. This move threatens checkmate on d8, and let's watch how. Let's make a free move. a6 is the free move. Queen to g7, we check. King to e8, queen to g8, we check. King to d7, and queen to d8, protected by the bishop. He checkmate. After bishop to a5, Jeffrey Xiong doesn't have good moves, and he tries to play something active at least. And he plays rook to c3. White can also capture directly the rook. Let's watch, because after bishop capture on c3 and d capture on c3, queen to f4, again with the idea of the checkmate in b8, queen to b6 we check, also protects from the checkmate, king to g2, king to e8 out of this threat, queen to e5 we check, king to d8, queen to d5, and the knight is gone, king to c8, rook capture the knight, attacking the queen, and then also will capture the other pawn, so it's game over. But Cordova, after rook to c3, he has other ideas in mind, but that they will lead to the same outcome. Bishop to b4 we check, king to e8, now bishop capture on c3 now, d capture on c3, queen to b5 we check, is also a second attack on the knight, king to d8, Cordova wants the king in a worse position, Queen to b8 we check, king to d7, now rook capture on b3, and black resigns because there is really nothing to do. So, what a game! It was an interesting opening that I don't see often. Then, later, interesting position to analyze and some calculations to do. So let me know in the comments if you also like this game. If you did, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. For now, thanks for watching and see you tomorrow. Goodbye.